In this video, I will show you how to install Home Assistant using Docker. And to make this setup complete, I'll also show you how to access this Home Assistant installation remotely from anywhere in the world for free using TwinGate Zero Trust Network, where Zero Trust Network is a modern, secure network model based on the assumption that trust can never be implicit. With TwinGate, I'll not deal with any complicated certificates creation procedures and I'll not open any ports in my network. But more on that later, because now I'll talk about Home Assistant and Docker. I'm going to install Docker on my laptop and then I'll use the install Docker to run both Home Assistant and TwinGate. You can use the same steps that I'm about to show on any device that supports Docker. So if you have a not very old laptop, PC, Raspberry Pi, even NAS device like Synology, or just something that can run Docker, you're good to go. And one more remark before we begin. Installing Home Assistant using Docker is also known as Home Assistant Container. This is one of the officially supported installations of Home Assistant. However, there are also three other official methods to get Home Assistant, and I'm discussing them in details in my free Home Assistant webinar. If you're interested, check it on my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Now, let's start with the Docker installation, and then we will continue with the Home Assistant and TwinGate. To download Docker, I'll go to docker.com, and I'll select Docker Desktop. I'll select my processor here, and the docker.dmg is downloaded on my computer. I'll open it, and I'll just drag the Docker to my applications folder. If you're using Windows, you have to click on the executable file, and then to click next several times, and you're ready. Docker is installed, and now I just have to start it. The procedure is not very different under Windows, but for Linux is. Fortunately, everything is well described on the docker.com webpage. So if you have difficulties, check for more info there. I'll start Docker by typing it in my Spotlight search. I'll click open here. Privileged access. Okay, I'm okay with that. I'll type my password. I'll accept the terms, and as you can see here in the upper right corner, this icon is thinking the Docker whale is moving. Docker Desktop is running. I also want to sign in Docker. If you don't have a user, just create one. I'll use my existing user. Okay, it remembers my password. I'll hit continue. Allow. I think I'm ready. Yes, I have signed in successfully in Docker and my Docker Desktop is running. That's what I wanted to see and accomplish here. Time to run Home Assistant Container, which is as easy as copy and pasting some commands. And as usual, you can get these commands from the video description. I'll start my terminal and I'll expand it just a little bit. Then I'll type makdir haconfig and I'll enter inside this newly created haconfig folder. If I type pwd, I can see my full path and I'm going to use this path in a moment. Then I'll execute this docker run command. It will create a container named Home Assistant. It will run with privileged access. It will restart unless it stops. It will have time zone Europe, Sofia, you can change that. Don't forget to replace your current time zone. The format is continent/city. For example, Europe/Paris. And it will use this newly created folder to store the Home Assistant config. Don't forget to replace the folder where you want to store the Home Assistant configuration files. When I hit enter, the Docker will download the Home Assistant image for me and will start it. Okay, the docker run command is finished. As you can see here, Now I can type ls to see that I have the configuration.yaml file, for example, and automations.yaml, and everything that is needed for the Home Assistant. If I type docker ps, I can also see that the Docker container is created and its status is up. Now if I open a new tab and type localhost colon 8123 as a port, I will see the Home Assistant welcome screen, and I can type my name, username and password here to create an account. Great! I managed to install Home Assistant using Docker. Installing Home Assistant Docker was easy, right? The only drawback of this Home Assistant container installation method is the lack of supervisor and add-on store inside Home Assistant. If you really need them, then you have to choose either Home Assistant OS or supervised installation. And once again, more info is available in my webinar. Anyways, now that my Home Assistant in Docker, aka Home Assistant container, is up and running, I want to have remote access to the installation from anywhere in one secure, modern and elegant way. And here comes TwinGate and their service. I'll open another tab and I'll type twingate.com. I'll select the pricing menu and I'll select the starter, the free plan of the TwinGate. Have in mind that TwinGate offers free and paid plans. I'll use the free TwinGate plan, which allows up to 5 users and 2 devices per user. And it is great for individuals like me or even small teams. Here I can choose any of the available options to login, but I'll select GitHub. I'll use GitHub to login. Of course, you can select any of the other options that are listed on the TwinGate webpage. I'll authorize TwinGate. I will type my work email here. My company name is Peryansky, for example, and my role is IT. Of course, you can select anything you wish here. How do you plan to use TwinGate? I'll select personal slash hobby projects. Are you able to deploy TwinGate on your own? I hope so, and I'll try to do that. I'll select yes, I'm able to run Cli commands. Name of your network will be Peryansky. I'll have network URL peryansky.twingate.com. And my network is built. Very, very good. Now I'll click on other remote network. The location will be AWS, but you can choose the others as well. The name will be Smash the Like. At remote network. And my TwinGate network is created. How easy was that? Next step is to add TwinGate connector. You can think of it like a client or piece of software that will help you connect your device to the secure TwinGate network. There are many ways to deploy a TwinGate connector, and they are all well described. But because I already have Docker up and running, I'll use it to deploy the TwinGate connector. It is very easy. I can now deploy a connector. I'll select Docker here, but also Linux, Manual, and Azure, and many, many options are available. I'll generate these tokens. I will re-authenticate again with GitHub. And if I scroll down a bit, I will see the tokens that are generated for me. And if I scroll a bit more, I can see the whole Docker run command, and I can copy this command and I just have to paste it in my terminal. Just like that, and I'll hit enter, and Docker will start to download the TwinGate image for me. I think I'm ready. If I scroll up a bit, I can see my connector, my TwinGate connector is not yet connected. But it should turn green very... Yes, it is! My TwinGate connector is connected. With this, I managed to set up a TwinGate connector on my laptop using Docker. As I already said, the same steps so far can be executed on any device that you wish as long as it supports Docker. As you probably remember, I'm interested in enabling remote access to my Home Assistant. So I'll just have to add it as a TwinGate resource. I'll go one step back to my Smash the Like remote network and I'll add a resource. I'll select this option right here, CIDR, and I'll type a label, for example, HA. As address, I'll type my laptop IP, which is available right here. So I'll just enter the same IP. As port, I'll type 8123, which is default one. And I will allow everyone to have access to this resource. And I'm ready. I'm completely ready. The HA resource is also green. Now I can try to access it from a remote device. Of course, I can add another resources. For example, if I have different services on this laptop that I want to access remotely, I just have to add another resource the same way. The final step that I have to do is to install a TwinGate client on the device that I want to use to access my Home Assistant remotely. There are available TwinGate clients for iOS, Android, Windows, Linux and Mac, so you can use any of these devices. I will show you the iOS client on my phone, but the steps are pretty similar for all other devices. Let's get that TwinGate client. This is my phone. I'll open the App Store and I'll type TwinGate. I'll double click to install this app. It is installed. I'll tap open. I'll hit continue here. I'll join a network. If you remember, my network was payansky.twingate.com. Now join the network. Allow VPN configurations. I'll enter my phone password here. And I'll have to sign in to connect. Continue. Again, I'll select the GitHub account and I have to type it. Fortunately, my phone remembers it. I have a two-factor authentication and I'm ready. Allow notifications, okay. I will allow that. And I'm seeing my HA TwinGate resource, which is my Home Assistant. And it is also green. I will now disable my Wi-Fi. I'll tap on the HA resource and I'll copy the address. I'll open a web browser and I'll paste the IP. Then I'll type column 8123 because this is the Home Assistant port. And as you can see, I'm able to access my Home Assistant remotely using a mobile data. I'm not in the same network as my Home Assistant at the moment because I'm using 5G. And I'm able to open the onboarding screen of my Home Assistant, which means that TwinGate is working for me and I have secure remote access to my Home Assistant. Pretty good! By the way, I have a quick challenge for you. Let me know what is your favorite Docker image. Maybe it's a Home Assistant, Node-RED or Mosquito MQTT, or something completely different. Please share it in the comments. And if you have hard time understanding some of the smart home words and abbreviations that I'm using in this video, I have a smart home glossary for you, which is available on payansky.com/glossary. Just go there and instantly download it. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!